that's going to be? We're going to find out. We have lung diseases that will restrict my pulmonary circulation. This means the circulation to my lungs. Blood flow to the lungs comes from the right side of the heart. So, one that's rather familiar, cor pulmonale. Blood flows from the one of the more common ones is the cor pulmonale. This is a term that you will encounter. Well, depending on what area of nursing you go into. But it is failure of my right ventricle. So looking at the structure of my heart, this is my right ventricle. Because I have two ventricles, two atria.
But it's not this area.
This area. Yeah. This would be my right ventricle. This would be my left. Okay. And then upper are my atria. So, something happens to cause the ventricle on the right side to not be functioning properly. Okay? If that happens, because it's my right ventricle that pushes the blood into the lungs, that doesn't happen correctly. So the blood flow to my lungs is obstructed. Could that be a problem all over? Yes, most definitely. Okay? This happens with emphysema, chronic bronchitis, black lung disease, tuberculosis, COPD is a whole other thing. So this would basically create a problem throughout the entire body.
You're saying the cor pulmonale.
The cor pulmonale, basically the failure of the right ventricle would create issues throughout the entire body. Now, in my structure that I've been trying to explain, when we look at our heart, like I was saying, the fist into the balloon, note that the balloon follows all of the contours of my hand. The outer portion creates the sac. So having this sac around my heart, I get to anchor to my diaphragm. I'll get to anchor to my sternum. This is kind of showing the three layers that are around the heart, where I'm going to have my serous membrane. I'm going to have my epicardium, this outer tough layer, the membrane that'll produce the fluid for the sac to decrease all of the friction. Okay? Now, let me think here for a second.
still haven't talked about myocardium. Hmm, wonder why. Hold on to that thought. All right. So, innermost layer, outermost layer. We've already looked at right now. We've looked at the sac. We've looked at the fluid. Hopefully, identified that we've got two atria, two ventricles. So, in that structure, my atria, top, ventricles, bottom, I have a right atria, left atria. They receive the blood. So on the right side of my heart, you can see that I have two major structures, two major vessels. That's what they're referred to, okay? They're referred to as major vessels. And their job from every single part of the body, return the blood to the right side. So, I've got one that's inferior. This is my inferior vena cava. I've got one superior. Because here's my heart. I've got parts of my body above it, parts of my body below it. So, I got an inferior and a superior vena cava. And they are going to return the blood for every part of my body to your heart. Think about that for a second. Just think about it. My two ventricles, got my left, my right, my left. Their job, get my blood to my major artery. Atria? I just didn't know, like, why. I just don't know what it is. That's why.
Okay, if you think about an atrium, all right? Okay? If we think about an atrium is referring to something that is upstairs, right? And so, atria for the heart, I guess we could say, are the upstairs portions. Does that make sense? And ventricles being the downstairs. Alright? Now, the job here, pump the blood into my major vessels. So, we gotta have some parts.
I love the heart.
It is such an amazing organ, okay? Now, in the structure that we have, do you guys remember the term sulcus from part one? A deep groove, okay? Some kind of line, okay? Look at our terminology, all right? And simply begin to take the terminology apart. It tells me I've got something called an atrioventricular sulcus. Now, atrio is going to be my,
up there
is my atrium, ventricular, my ventricle. This is telling me I've got like this division between the two. Do I have two sides with atrium and ventricle?
Yeah.
Yes. So, it would stand to reason left and right. A division between them. And then we have a interventricular sulcus. Which chambers is that referring to? Between what? Between what chambers? My ventricles. So this is telling me between my two ventricles, the right and the left, I have a sulcus. Why am I needing to have all of this division between all of these chambers of the heart? So what doesn't run into each other? The blood. Deoxygenated, oxygenated? Yes. That's simple.
So are there diseases where like people have issues where they run into?
Oh yeah.
No.
Mm-hmm. Now. If I've got, well, Destiny, let's go back a second. Okay? Because I've been talking about it in reference to the inside of the heart. And they're looking at it in reference to what we have on the outside. I'm sorry. Now take me out and beat me up later. Okay? So, what we're wanting you to look at, if I have the line in between atria, ventricle, the line in between atria, ventricle, okay? And then if I have the line between my two ventricles, what do you see existing in every single line? My arteries and my veins. The coronary arteries and veins. All right? So, let me think about this for a second. If I look at this structure, like put your hearts back together. I know it sounds really weird, right? Okay. Take a peek at the vessels and their pathways. Now, when you look at this structure, do you notice the representation on the left of the size of those vessels versus the right? They're bigger on which side?
On the left.
On the left. And then, if I look at what happens as we run down the heart, what do I see occurring to each side? Branching. And if I look on the posterior side, I see the same thing taking place. All right? This is the pathway that when the blood from my coronary circulation gets pumped into the artery, that it can pass and feed all of these tissues of my heart. If those tissues, those cells, had to have a blood supply, that means they're doing something and they're making waste, and I've got to have that blood return back to the heart. And that makes up my coronary circulation. The blood supply to the heart doesn't go to other tissues of the body. It goes strictly to the heart tissue. Now for the chambers, open your heart back up. We'll have a septum. Do you remember what a septum was from part one? A divider. Now look at our terminology. Interatrial. So it's where?
Between
what? My atria. Now, if I look at the structure of my heart to the inside, and I look at this, does it look kind of weird on the inside? Look like it's got some huge projection off of it on both the left and the right, these little mountains almost that it looks like? Okay. These are pectinate muscles. They are in both sides of the heart. What do you notice about their size between the left and the right?
Larger on the left.
I have an interventricular septum between ventricles. And trabeculae carniae. Whew, somebody got real inventive in lab that day. Okay? That's almost as much fun as medulla oblongata. Alright? Trabeculae carniae. These are ridges, and we believe it might help ventricles, basically the wall of this ventricle, from sticking together after the heart contracts. All right. When the heart beats, does it beat as just one action? The individual action of every single cell coordinated to make it look like it's one action.
Pretty cool.
It's all based off of the electricity. Where do we get the electricity from? Well, that's going to be our pacemaker for the beat of the heart. But the electricity for the cells themselves, ions. Going back to sodium, potassium, calcium, zinc, magnesium, and that individual cell, how does, what does that say to you in the class? Everything goes back to the cellular level. I mean, is that just not the coolest duet?
I said that's unfortunate because I don't know that.
So if I look at my structure, this is it. All right. Now, looking at this, what do you think? It is complex, but it's not complicated. It is, but it isn't. Yeah,
they
it's
on the
shape.
Right and on the left.
This is termed a pump. Okay? And if you think about a pump, all right, for example, think about a pump on a well. All right? It's doing an action over and over and over. It is like a machine. Now, we're going to find that some of these structures are where the things can go wrong with the heart. Luckily, we have come a long way in heart surgery, and therefore, we've come a long way in being able to fix some of these parts that can go wrong, where even, you know, of course, to the point where heart transplants are more common now than they ever were to begin with. Well, we're doing that with lots of organs, you know, organ transplants. I mean, look at what's just down the street from us here at campus. Have y'all ever noticed the UNOS building? Okay, the United Network of
Organ Transplants.
Organ Sharing.
Yeah.
Okay, huge building. And that's all we deal with, databases of the organ transplant. I mean, wow. I want to go in there so bad and just talk to them. But, you know, they're locked down. They have to be. You know, too much information. But, man, I love going in and just talk to somebody. One of the parts of the heart that plays a very important part and makes sure that our blood through the heart moves correctly. The valves. Turn your heart back upside down. And note. See how we've got like the little, I think for y'all, it looks like a little piece of paper with the stuff tied, with stuff, the little strings, okay? We're going to see that we have atrioventricular valves, meaning between my atria and my ventricle. So, that's going to be the ones that look like the little white pieces of paper in your heart. Okay?
What are the white pieces of paper again?
The valves.
Valves.
Okay, the white paper that you have in yours, mine, this one's plastic. Okay? These are atrioventricular valves. On the right side, the one that we have as the right AV. Right AV, three cusps. When you look at this structure, what is a cusp? Not the string, but what the strings are hanging from. The cusp is what they're trying to represent as the full paper portion. And on the right side, They're trying to represent that there's three. They're trying to do it in like little waves.
So like what the vowels are hanging from?
No. That is the vowel. It's the pointy parts of your paper.
I thought you said the crust was like hanging from it.
The crust has the string hanging from it.
Okay. So this
is trying to represent the cup. And they're trying to show it with a little dip. Like this would be a cup. Okay? It's this part right here, and they're trying to use this as representing the cup. We commonly know, because the right one has three, we commonly refer to this one as tricuspid. Have you ever heard